Good morning. This is Pastor Steve from Victory Harbor. We're glad you guys are in the service today. Today's nugget is nail the colors to the mask. I guess I need to sort of explain what colors are. Colors is a military term for our flag. In other words, our flag's very important to a military person. They will fight and give their life and die for that very flag. When you strike the colors, that means you surrender, you quit, you give up. But we don't ever need to strike the colors. We need to raise the colors, lift them high, raise that banner of the Lord and say, we're not taking it down. We're going to stand on this forever. In the late 1990s, we dealt with biker clubs in the Greenville, Tennessee area. And their colors were very, very important to them. Now, their colors wasn't a flag, but it was the patches they wore on their back. And colors in a biker club was very hard to obtain. When you come in, you had to be sort of like a slave. You went through an initiation process, and you were just like a slave. You had to do everything they asked you to do, even give your life for them if it was necessary. But once you got those colors, you could never take them off. They were yours. And you wore them with pride, and if an enemy come and you would die before you would let them get your colors, you wouldn't surrender at all. Now, many, 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 many years ago, there was two ships sailing into the Caribbean Sea. They were about a day apart. Now, the first ship was captained by a very wealthy captain. He had a lot of money and everything going his way. Well, when he sailed into the Caribbean, the pirates seen him, and they started going towards him. And he saw the pirates coming. Well, he didn't want to fight, so he said, strike the colors. We're going to give up. We're going to surrender. We're going to quit. They know we're wealthy. They won't hurt us. Very foolish man. Very foolish. He thought money could buy him everything. He ended up, him and his crew, marooned on an island for 3 or 4 years. You cannot give up to the devil. The devil's always after you. Don't quit. Don't stop. Keep pressing on. We need to learn to nail the colors to the mast. Now, this next ship that was coming in the next day, he came in, the pirates seen them too. And the captain seen the pirates. So he gave the order, go nail the colors to the mast. In other words, they took their flag, nailed it into that mast. There's no way they was going to surrender. There's no way they was going to give up. There was no way they were going to quit. That pirate ship was looking through his spyglass, and he seen them nailing to the colors to the mast, and he knew what that meant. That meant that they were going to fight to the death. They would not quit. They would not stop. They would not give in. So that pirate said, it's not worth the trouble. We're going to lose too many people. And he sailed away. That's sort of how the devil is. The Bible says we need to resist him and he will flee from us. We can't quit. We can't stop. We need to learn to nail the colors to the mast. Today we're going into the book of James chapter 4 verse 7. I'm going to read two different versions this morning. So bear with us. The first one is from the King James. It says, submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Now the next scripture is from the same scripture, but from the Message. So let God work his will in you. Yell a loud no to the devil and watch him scamper. Watch him flee. Watch him leave. If we would learn to nail the colors to the mast, say no to the devil, everything will be all right. We cannot let surrender, quit, give up, stop be in our vocabulary. We must press on like Paul said. Press on to the mark of the higher call of God. We cannot stop. We cannot give in. Now when Daniel and the children of Israel were brought into Babylon in bondage, they picked certain ones and they wanted to educate them in the Babylonian ways. So they set them up and they were going to give them Babylonian food, which was against Jewish law to eat the food that the Babylonians ate. Now, Daniel could quit. He could say, I give up. I'm in bondage. I'm going to quit. But he said, no, devil, I'm not. spirit that was over them tried them for a period of time, and they were more healthy than the other children. Because Daniel decided he had nailed the colors to the mast. He wasn't giving in. He wasn't quitting. God bless him. Now, we look at the story of Joseph. He's sold by his brothers into bondage. He's sold to an Egyptian named Potiphar, and everything's going pretty good for Joseph. He's prospering, everything in Potiphar's house is prospering. And then Potiphar's wife decides she wants to seduce him. Now he's going to give in. And everything would have probably went smooth, but it wouldn't have been right, because it's not God's way. But what did Joseph do? He nailed the colors to the mast. He said, "No, ma'am, I'm not doing that. I'm not involved in that. I serve the living God. I am not falling into this trap." See, we need to learn to stand on the Word of God. Nail the colors to the mast. Say, "No, devil, no, devil, no, devil. I'm not going your way. No, devil, you're not winning. No, devil, you don't have the victory. I have the victory." We need to purpose that in our heart. Now, when Peter and John had healed a lame man and preaching in the name of Jesus, all the rulers and the authorities said, "Don't be teaching in this name anymore." They could have quit. They could have said, "Oh, there's a cross waiting for me if I do." But they went on. They wouldn't quit. They nailed the colors in the mast and said, "You decide. Is it better to obey you or to obey God?" They obeyed God. What will you do in your life if you're facing a certain situation like that? We need to say, "I'm not giving in to the devil. I'm nailing the colors to the mast. I'm standing on the Word of God. I'm not going to quit." Now, the three Hebrew children were given a choice. They said, "When you hear the sound of music, bow down to this idol and everything will be all right." And they said, "No, we ain't going to do it." He said, "Well, I'll throw you in the furnace of fire if you don't." They said, "Go ahead, we still ain't quit. Do you think your God will deliver you from that furnace of fire?" Said, "Whether he does or not, we're not falling down and worshiping a false God." They nailed the colors to the mast. They stood on the Word of God. The king became angry and he said, "Heat that furnace up 7 times hotter than it's ever been." The people, the soldiers that threw him into the fiery furnace, died. But in the midst of that fiery furnace was one like unto the Son of God. And the smoke didn't even get on those Hebrew children. Why? Because of God's mercy. Why? Because they purpose in their heart. They're not giving up. They're not quitting. They nail the colors to the mast. How about you? Maybe you're facing issues today. Maybe the devil is tempting you. And maybe you think, "Well, I can just give in to this temptation." But we can't do that. We can't stop. We can't quit. We got to nail the colors of the mast. "No, devil, you get your junk and get it out of my house. Get your junk and get it out of my mind. I am not going into that trap." Maybe he's telling you it's hopeless. It's useless. Nothing's going to ever work for you. Nail the colors to the mast and say, "Satan, you're a liar. Flee from me. Get away from me right now. Lord Jesus, I ask you to rebuke that devil in my life." Stand on the Word of God. Watch him flee. The Bible says if we resist the devil, he will flee. I like what the Message said there. Yell a loud no to the devil and watch him scamper away. He can't stand before you if you're standing on the Word of God. Maybe he is attacking you with sickness. Maybe you got all kinds of symptoms today. Don't look at those symptoms. The Bible says, "By the stripes of Jesus we are healed. Diseases will not come near our dwelling." Stand on the Word of God. Nail the colors to the mast. "No, devil, you ain't taking me out." No. The Word says, "I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord." Stand on the Word of God. That's what we've got to do. Maybe he's attacking your finances. Maybe it seems that You run out of money before you run out of the end of the week, and things are not good. The Lord is the one that gives us the ability to obtain wealth. We must learn to nail the colors to the mast. Maybe He's just wearing you out and put an enemy in your life. Maybe that enemy's reared up so big he's like Goliath that David fought. Let me tell you something, he's just a pipsqueak, he's a devil. Nail the colors to the mast, say, "No, devil, you're not getting here, you're not getting your way." And watch that enemy perish. Watch that enemy melt away as if he's just a snowman when heat hits him. Watch what God will do for you in your life. God's good, isn't He? Maybe the devil has tried to hinder your calling. Resist the devil, nail the colors to the mast and say, "No, I am going to preach the word. No, I'm going to stand and teach that Sunday school class. No, I'm going to lead singing in this church. Devil, you're not getting my calling. You're not messing with my life." Now, I want to tell you the best issue that I know of, when the real colors, the true colors, was nailed to the mast, is when Jesus was nailed to the cross. He died for my sins and your sins. He took our place. Maybe the devil is just messing with you today. I say to you, nail the colors to the mast. Resist him and watch him scamper away. He's good. Can I get an amen from you guys today? He is good. Amen. We need to purpose in our heart. We're not giving up, no matter what the situation is. We're not quitting. We're not stopping. We're not slowing down. We're not even going to take a break, God. We're pushing on for God. We're going to push on. We're going to walk on. Press on. Sometimes it's a pressing way. Sometimes you've got to make yourself get up. David had to stir himself up. It's in your mind. You've got to work it. You've got to push and believe the Word of God. Now, I've got a question for you. Are you in relationship with the Son of God? Have you found Him? Have you surrendered your life to Him? Have you confessed your sins to Him? Do you know Him? Do you know Him personally? Are you in relationship with the Son of God? If you're not, I pray that you do. In closing, let us pray. Father, I ask you to give us all strength. If the devils come knocking, Lord, give us the ability to nail the colors to the mast, Lord, and resist him. If there's anybody out there that's listening today that's not accepting you, I ask you, God, to reveal yourself to them, Father. And give them the strength to accept you as their Savior. We ask you, Lord, that you would save the lost in this world. Father, that you would feed the hungry. That you would shelter the homeless. And move in all of our life. Bring us, Lord, to that place where we're hungry for you. Where you're the desire of our life. We thank you and ask it in Jesus' name. Thank you for being in the service today. God bless you.